After what Apple said at WWDC about Final Cut and how they highlighted DaVinci Resolve has really sealed Final Cut's fate to be more of a CapCut competitor than a serious professional editing tool. And I've completely lost confidence and hope for the future pro version of Final Cut Pro. Final Cut Pro came out 13 years ago and it has been a bargain for anyone that bought it back then. Free updates, free add-ons, and steadily improving. It has been my go-to for creating content. I regularly choose it over the other NLEs if I'm working on a personal project or as a crew of one. But recently, more and more, it's not my go-to for professional work. It's because I am needing third-party tools and apps to get the same level of quality and speed of workflow that I can in DaVinci Resolve. Final Cut has never been cross-platform, which is fine for the most part for a crew of one, but I work with a team that have different tools that they need access to. So it's a mixed Windows machine and macOS environment. Working in Final Cut has become more of a hassle to convert the edits than to just open the timeline when passing off projects to different team members. Will Final Cut continue to be a great and stable tool as Apple keeps updating it with new features? Yeah, of course. But my confidence that it will be my one-stop shop for all things content is very unlikely moving forward, especially with the latest 10.8 release, where they added some new features that are kind of cool, but nothing that was ground shattering or anything too exciting. You can rename the color layers. Fantastic. That would have been great 4 years ago. So I know that they said they're going to have an update in the fall.
Spatial videos can then be edited in Final Cut Pro for Mac. This new professional workflow will be available this fall.
So I'm holding out a little bit of hope that there may be some banger that they release then. For anyone that uses Final Cut as a crew of one and doesn't have to work with other editors, it's fantastic. It's stable and fast on Mac hardware. And if you bought it years ago when they released it, it's definitely worth the initial investment. Apple at WWDC briefly mentioned Final Cut Pro and how it will get Vision Pro editing capabilities in the fall of this year to be able to edit spatial video. But they also announced that DaVinci Resolve would also get the same thing.
Apple Immersive Videos are 180-degree 8K recordings with spatial audio that give you mind-blowing experiences with lifelike fidelity. To enable creators to bring their own stories to life with Apple Immersive Video, we've partnered first with Blackmagic Design, a leading innovator in creative video technology, to build a new production workflow consisting of Blackmagic cameras, DaVinci Resolve Studio, and Apple Compressor. These will all be available to creators later this year.
And Apple even showcased the Blackmagic Design specialty camera for capturing spatial video. And me watching this seemed to suggest very heavily that Apple is leaning on Blackmagic to provide the professional path to making spatial content, and Apple will handle the consumer-made content. There is nothing wrong with this approach. This partnership does lend itself nicely to Apple's plan. Apple makes consumer products, Blackmagic makes products for professionals. In my opinion, it's a great team up, and it does secure Apple's spatial video content that they're really pushing. It's just not great for the future of Final Cut Pro as a pro editor. I feel Final Cut Pro will remain and further continue down the path as mostly a consumer-friendly application. I just can't see Apple suddenly shifting gears and going pro when Blackmagic Design is doing that with DaVinci Resolve and Apple's core customer is the consumer. Will Final Cut Pro get great updates? Yes, I do believe so. They will get great AI features with Apple Intelligence, and I'm pretty sure there are some pretty cool updates planned. But it will be more for ease of use, like AI captions, silence removals, auto color grading, simple effects for audio and video cleanup, spatial audio editing and mixing, better tracking, easy collaborations with other individuals, maybe even generative content eventually. These are all great add-ons. But Blackmagic Design at the same time will also keep adding tools for the professional workflow. Precise color grading, visual effects, especially for spatial video, real-time collaborations with other professionals and studios. Consumers love Final Cut Pro for its ease of use. Pros love DaVinci Resolve for its precise capabilities. So at this point, I feel that Final Cut Pro and DaVinci Resolve are diverging into their own niches and customer profiles. The consumer and professional. That's why I feel that Final Cut Pro is going to be more of a CapCut competitor than a professional editing tool. Now, don't get me wrong, I love Final Cut Pro. Even last year, I made a whole course dedicated to it called Enhanced Editing for anyone that has Final Cut Pro and wants to get the most out of it. And for that, it's great. I'm just finding it harder and harder to use it professionally. And by that, I mean on higher end productions. And combined with all the bad press that Adobe's had lately, it's really pushing people towards DaVinci Resolve. I genuinely hope that I am wrong and that this fall, Apple drops a massive update, thrusting Final Cut Pro into the forefront of what we all know it can be. And if you're on the fence on which app is right for you, in this video, I go over the workflow in more detail between Final Cut Pro and DaVinci Resolve to help you choose. So make sure you check that out. As always, thanks for watching.